You're watching the most trending news around the globe on Daily Top 10, brought to you by your favorite entertainment channel. At number 10, Rejoice Iweze of Destiny Kids is married. Popular Nigerian singer and vlogger Rejoice Chidinma Iweze, who rose to prominence at a tender age as a member of the popular family music group Destiny Kids and is known for her song Joy, 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 has now tied a knot in a traditional marriage. Rejoice, who got engaged to a data analyst, heartthrob Oladayo Temitayo Samuel in September, shared exciting news of a traditional marriage which took place in Owerri in Imo State. In an Instagram post accompanied by several pictures, the former child star said, and I quote, "It's a new dawn, it's a new level, it's a new chapter. The next level is just bubbling in my heart and I'm super excited I'm doing this with you." End of quote. Hearty cheers to the newest couple. At number 9, UFC star Israel Adesanya arrested in the United States of America. This season doesn't seem to be the best of seasons for Nigerian New Zealander, professional mixed martial arts kickboxer and former boxer Israel Adesanya, who recently lost to Brazilian professional mixed martial arts and former kickboxer Alex Pereira, as he is now currently at the risk of facing a one-year jail term. The Ultimate Fighting Championship fighter has been arrested and taken to custody after a set of brass knuckles were found in his possession while going through a routine check at the airport. The possession of the items, which are illegal in the USA, unfortunately, means that Adesanya might be barred from leaving New York until the ongoing investigation is concluded. At number 8, reality TV star Madison LaCroix is married. 32-year-old reality TV star of Southern Charm and mother of one, Madison LaCroix, has tied a knot with Brett Randall in an intimate Charleston, Charles Carolina courthouse ceremony ahead of the actual wedding date, which is scheduled for 19th of November. Madison, who shared a video collage that documents their beautiful day on her Instagram page, got engaged in October 2021 after 7 months of dating, will be appearing before a small group of family and friends at a tropical destination ceremony. This will be an everlasting love. This will be the one I've waited for. This will be the first time anyone. At number 7, Senate probes on even distribution of 500 billion naira loans. The Senate has set up a 7-member ad hoc committee led by Senator Sani Musa to probe the uneven disbursement of half a trillion naira loan by the Development Bank of Nigeria, which was established to alleviate financial constraints faced by micro, small, and medium-scale businesses in Nigeria. The loan, which was meant to be shared equally across 6 geopolitical zones, was not, and according to Senator Ali Ndume, in his submission before the Senate, he disclosed that a recent data obtained from the bank's annual integration statutory report showed that the Southwest had access to a total of 57% of the 500 billion naira loan estimated to be worth 273 billion, while the Northeast accessed only 1% of the total monies that is estimated at 43.8 billion. The committee, which is expected to feed the House back in 2 weeks, is made up of Senator Musa representing the Niger East, Senator Ibrahim Dambaba, Sokoto South, Ayo Akinyelure, Ondo Central, Matthew Ugohide, Edo South, Ali Ndume, Borno South, Lillian Ekunife, Anambra South, and Sadiq Umar representing Kwara North. At number 6, Mr. Easy reveals his choice performing act for his wedding. Award-winning Nigerian-born Ghanaian-based singer, songwriter, and music entrepreneur Oluwatosin Ajibade, popularly known as Mr. Easy, has in a couple of Twitter threads announced that for his forthcoming wedding to his fashion enthusiast and Belinda daughter lover, Timi Otedola, he would only have popular R&B and pop music group Star Plus and legendary Tubaba grace the beautiful occasion with their performances. Sharing the latest development with his fans on his Bird app, Mr. Easy said, and I quote, "I beg, not only Star Plus I want for my wedding. Okay, sorry, and Tubaba too." The Lovebird, who have teased on having a private ceremony, shared a romantic relationship for 6 years, got engaged on April 10th, 2022. I don't wanna do no curl, baby, make we legalize. My world is stop anytime you look into my eyes. Even if you don't know, baby, I gon' make you realize. I don't gon' let you go, baby, now you be my wife. At number 5, N-Dubs announces 2023 concert for Scarborough. English hip-hop trio N-Buzz from Camden Town, London, made up of Tulisa, Dappy, and Phaser, that made a comeback with the release of Chama earlier this year, have announced that as part of the 2023's tour, they will be having an open-air concert at Scarborough, a seaside town in Borough of Scarborough in North England. The trio, who are currently on their Back to the Future tour, which is their first in 11 years, have through their career sold a total of 1.3 million albums, with the first two, Uncle B and Against All Odds, certified platinums in the UK. At number 4, Victor Osimhen nominated for Serie A Player of the Month Award. Having lost his first Serie A Player of the Month Award in September, 23-year-old Nigerian international professional footballer Victor James Osimhen, who plays as a striker for Serie A club Napoli and Nigerian national team, has yet again been nominated in the same award category for the second consecutive time, having scored a total of 10 goals in all competitions this season. In September, the Nigerian international was nominated alongside fellow countryman Ademola Lookman, but both players lost the award to AC Milan player Rafael Leao. For this month's Serie A Player of the Month Month award. However, the 23-year-old striker is nominated alongside football stars like Piotr Zielinski, Moise Keane, Federico Di Marco, and Guillermo Bonaventura. At number 3, federal government disburses $700 million Abacha loot. The federal government, through acting national coordinator of NASCO, Kabir Abdullahi, recently disclosed that it has, through the National Social Safety Net Coordinating Office, NASCO, disbursed a sum of $700 million from the Abacha looted fund to over 1.9 million Nigerian vulnerable households in the last 6 years. Disclosing this at a one-day dissemination meeting by the Center for Health Education, Economic Rehabilitation and Social Security chairs, the acting coordinator said that the project entails disbursing on a monthly basis conditional cash transfer of 10,000 naira and basic cash transfer of 5,000 naira to poor and vulnerable households. At number 2, Portugal beats Nigeria in an international friendly. As if it's not enough that the Nigerian Super Eagles will not be among the 32 teams participating in the 64 games slated for the FIFA World Cup in Qatar between November 20 and December 18. Led by Andre Silva in Cristiano Ronaldo's absence, Portugal have gone ahead to beat Nigerian Super Eagles led by Willem Troost Ekong in their first ever meet in a whooping 4-0 friendly on Thursday night. The game, which took place at a 50,000 capacity Estadio Jose Alvalade in Lisbon, saw Portugal possess the ball more in a 64% to 38% margin and also saw 644 passes from Portugal as against Nigeria's 407 passes, had goals from Bruno Fernandes, Gonzalo Ramos and João Marinho. Just like Cristiano Ronaldo on the Portuguese side, Ahmed Musa, Victor Osimhen and Olisander on the Nigerian team were also absent. At number 1, Dice Ailes drops video for Hold Me. Popular Nigerian-Canadian singer, songwriter and rapper Dice Ailes, who rose to prominence after signing a record deal with Chocolate City in 2014, has released the anticipated visuals for his hit song Hold Me off his debut EP Ladies First, and it features Afrobeat's queen Tiwa Savage. The 3 minutes and 15 seconds video, which was shot in Toronto under the creative direction of Eniola Yusuf and Dice Ailes, is an absolute show of beautiful, creative, mature friendship and freedom that shows both artists do their thing without trying too hard to let you know that they're absolutely the best. And that's all we can take on today's edition of Daily Top 10. For more information, follow us on all our social media platforms for updates. Thank you for tuning in. Bye for now.